take a minute, not a break, take a minute to go back over and begin writing down some of the ideas that y'all might have had, and give you about 10 minutes, and then we're going to start putting those together as a collective set of goals. Is that all right?
Have we discussed what they know? I mean, really?
Yeah, peaches.
Peace. No, I think it's gold.
Are you asking us to put down what we turned in today?
No, I mean, if something that you have learned that you think is noteworthy and you want to set that as a goal.
Doesn't take any time out of the staff's
daily schedule to attend the work session. They have to take time out of their daily schedule, if you want to say that, in the evenings to come to the works, I mean, to the regular meetings in, after hours. They would love to go on at 5 o'clock. All of them would. Now, they know what their job duties are, they know what their responsibilities are, and that's part of that. So they work around that every 2 weeks of having to be there from 5 o'clock on until we're through with the regular session. But I think then if you change it to an after hours or earlier or later, then you're going to put more of a burden on their personal time to be there for the work session, where I really don't see a huge benefit to where, again, if we can accomplish some of these other goals, I know from my standpoint, Paige and I do the radio shows, we go over the agenda items every Monday morning at 7 o'clock on the Scott James show. I'm sure everybody will listen to Scott James. But we talk about it all the time that the agenda items are available on the website. Let everybody know that they can go and see what that business is going to be. Now, we also know how the structure of a work session is. And the structure of a work session is just that. It's the opportunity for the commissioners to get information and feedback from staff. There is no dialogue or no participation from the citizens during a work session. It would just be a set and listen process. But that's really all it would be. There is a greater opportunity for the citizens to be involved in the process of the county commissioners doing their job at the regular session, which they have full opportunity at their citizens to be wishing to be heard, whether they have a zoning case, whatever that situation may be. The citizens participate on that aspect of it. So I really don't see a big advantage, again, personally, changing the hours of the work session, because all you're really going to do is put a larger burden on staff to get more of their personal time to do the work session, to where I felt like it works great just like it is.
And like I said, I prefer to find a way because the one improve the citizens' trust, because if you get this trust, at the end of the day, at the work session, you don't have anybody there. And then you get to the meeting, you don't have anybody there. And even because they told you already, you made a decision. And then if they want to talk to that citizen to be heard, it's at the very end of the meeting. And they got 5 minutes to express themselves after all the decisions and every opportunity to hear anything about an issue that's taking place. And I want to put that out there, so therefore,
I don't
represent my constituents.
I got it. Let me say that.
It's not on my behalf, but I really hesitated to even submit it because I didn't want nobody to feel it was on my behalf. But I've been hearing it since I got on the commission, and then more importantly, the last couple months or so. And that's why I wanted to walk forward.
Ms. Evans has a comment.
I'm not
going to
be able to. When I first started with the county, meetings was at, the work session was at, I think, 3 o'clock.
Oh, yeah, it was.
And you leave the work session, and you're going to meet at 5:30.
4:30.
And it was on the list. All of it was right there. You said that. It, to me, that was the most horrible thing because you try to figure out what's on the agenda, and you have to make a decision. That's in an hour, so I'm going to bring you information. So that was the hardest thing. So I worked hard to try to get the meeting changed. It took us about 3 or 4 months to figure out what day that would work better. So to me, it's hard to have a meeting the same day that you want to have in the work session. So we ended up with the work session on Monday next time was the regular meeting. During that time, nobody came to the meetings. After we have a meeting, if they weren't coming, nobody came to any of the meetings at any of the times, unless there's something they wanted to express. So we can change it to whatever time. It's different if they're not too sure if this is something that we want to express themselves. So I know I've been to both of those, and to me, it's working together. This way.
You can't make these people care.
Yeah.
I mean, look behind them.
Yeah. I'm just saying the biggest critique is, you know, once again, the citizens to be heard portion that's taking place after everything that's taking place where no public Even the citizens don't get a chance to hear us really discuss and actually realize that we're really thinking about something, or it's just not one or two people making the shots.
I think they got all the opportunity in the world if they want to come to it. I'm going to talk a little bit about what Miss Evans said. Talk about this procedure right here. Where's our participation at? Where's the citizens at? We've set up a half a dozen chairs plus more here for citizens, and there's nobody here. I don't know until the citizens begin. I'm sorry, not nobody, but all
the rest of them are at work.
But here at work, at 8:30 in the morning is what he's all saying.
Well, I don't think I don't see right now changing. Because what are you going to change it to? Are you going to move your regular meeting to a Wednesday night and then do Monday night work session? Or how do you want to change that?
I don't think it's the time. I hear clearly what Commissioner Marshall's saying, and I've heard some of the same thing. I don't think it's the time. I think people will make efforts to be there if it concerns them. We see that in some of the.
You see it in your own case, actually.
But I do think, and I think it's something noteworthy that we should discuss more often. I mean, how do we make citizens feel like their opinion matters? And because they'll tell you, some folks have told me, I'll say it that way, that everything does seem predetermined. Everything seems so rough. We've had previous chairman say, meet done in 9 minutes and 37 seconds, and it seems to be. So how do we? I don't care about the times. I think our time for work session and a regular meeting, I think all that's fine. But how do we begin to make people feel more welcome and engaged and without disrupting the process?
Didn't we just talk about that? What the page was saying with that social media stuff?
Well, I'm saying the perception that, it's rubber stamp and stuff. It's, runs the agenda as fast as you can. I'm trying to differ between efficiency and
I can understand it, but also you change the citizens to be heard, in my opinion. The citizens to be heard is not necessarily to be heard about a specific agenda item. It's an issue that citizen has that they would like to see the county commissioners address. If it's an agenda item, they've got just as much access to you 24/7. Don't call me. My cell phone is on. You can get in touch with me anytime you want to. And if there's an agenda item that you want to discuss with me, you're more than welcome to call. And citizens do that. But to put it out there in the standpoint of the work session that we end up in a position that we're debating, you might say, every agenda item as it comes up, that's really not, we're not serving the best of the citizens. What you'll end up doing is end up with a few folks that will come to every meeting and they'll stand there and they'll want to give you their opinion about what you should do about this specific agenda item. The citizens, if you have your accessibility, like I've been talking about, the citizens are going to call on you. They're going to let you know what's going on in this community so that you can react to their needs. That's how you serve the citizens.
My biggest stance is, and I tell them all, I have nothing to hide. Whatever goes on in the meeting, y'all welcome to come. I do realize everybody's working at that time frame. I realize you want to hear and at least know that we care and put some thought into our discussion. However, I can't make that call. If they come to the meeting at 5:30, they're out there in 10 minutes, and so a lot of times,
Every citizen, if they look at that agenda and they have an interest in what's going on or an item on that agenda, they can come to the meeting and listen to it. They're going to get just as much information out of that meeting, regular meeting, as they did out of the work session. Just as much information. There's just as much discussion on the regular meeting as we generally have in the work session. Would y'all agree with that? Yeah. Because you've got more information about that particular agenda item, and there's other questions. There's tons of questions all the time that comes up from the work session to the next evening when we have the regular meeting. So I believe there's more discussion between the commissioners at the regular meeting than there is at the work session. We're primarily listening at what staff is feeding to us at the work session. That's the purpose of it. We then take that information, working through our process, process that, ask the questions then at that time that we need, and sometimes it requires the staff to go back and get additional information that they're not going to be able to give you if you turn to them at a work session and say, I want to know this. They may not give you that information right off the top of their head. They have to go back and do the research. So they go back and do the research, and we all experience it, and then come to the regular meeting, we've got more information and we're better informed, and then we can ask these questions that we felt like it needed to be asked. We ask if they're better informed, they can provide that information, and the citizens are right there to hear. You know, I don't buy into this deal about that the citizens don't have an opportunity to participate in the meetings. They can come to any meeting that we've got. They normally don't have the opportunity to participate zero in a work session. They come to a regular meeting, and they can sit there and listen to the proceedings, go through the process. If it's a public hearing case, they get their time, they can do what can say what they need to say there and argue their case. And then you've got, at the end of the meeting, you've got the citizens who wish to be heard. I'll listen to 25 of them if they line up there. If they want, we never turn down a citizen. You do go through the process. We will stay right there and listen to every concern that they got. And then I think the process as it is and as it has developed over the years works fine. That's me.
And maybe someone won't have a question to ask if they hear us discussing what's going on, because also when they begin to talk, they're limited to 5 minutes on the topic. So if you got 4 or 5 people that might have a set interest or question, they can't really ask it or, well, I guess it doesn't come very fast. But I'm just saying, they got that small window of expression.
I never fail to tell any of those citizens that there, if you want to discuss this further, I'll make myself available to you as long as you want to following this meeting. And I never walk out on a citizen that wants to further discuss an issue that they're talking about. I don't believe that the process is broken.
If any time in our history we have a mistrust of government, I think it's now.
Well, but I also think a lot of the people say, oh, well, y'all already decided, you know, what's the point of me coming? You know, I mean, we hear a lot of that.
Because
it will ask the work session.
If I have a question, I'll call Mr. Pritchett. You know, where time, even the night I call him and say, explain this to me, because I'm not going to call the chair and say, explain this to me. So if it's something that's in my work list that I don't understand and I need, so they would have time to get somebody to do it to me and say, but I get calls. The only call that I had that was concerned about, I believe, is say, if I don't get that 5:30 and I don't want to talk, I can't pass my paper in, you know. And so I said, well, just let us know, and I said, somebody can talk to you about it afterwards, and I want to fix it, I want to express myself. And there are sometimes a few people that came in, and it's 5:30, and they don't have time to fill that paper out and turn it in, and still have something the citizen would be heard, that they use that opportunity.
What were you going to say about it? I was just going to say, a lot of times, this information the staff gives us, they give us all the information, so not. To me, there's not a ton of questions we have to ask. I mean, if you read the books and you look at all the information they've given you, I mean, it's easy to take all the information and make a decision based on it. You know, there's very few questions that need to be asked about a lot of this stuff. I mean, if you got 3 bids and the lowest bid is $18,000,
I mean, it is as simple as that.
I mean, it's, you know, they give us all the information, you know, and I mean, it's, and then we talk about it, you know, they say, okay, you know, we got 3 bids, and the lowest bid from so-and-so at $18,000, and we vote on it and vote on that bid. What else is there to talk about? There's no other discussion. I mean, really, if we want to do it, if we don't want to do it, we say, oh, we don't want to build, you know, but
So I think part of it has to do with how staff gives us the information and the amount of information they give us. And if they just said, okay, we got to, if they walked in on the work session Monday morning meeting, they said, okay, we got to replace the work pump. Well, where's the work pump? What kind of work pump? Well, we'll get that information. Well, you know, we talked about it for 30 minutes about replacing a water pump. When if they come in and said, we got this water pump at this location, that's doing this, that, you know, this is what it is, this is what we replace it with, this is what it's going to cost, y'all will do that, right? Okay, yeah, we want to do it because we need to fix it.
And at the end of the day, what's going to happen?
We're going to fix the pump. Yeah. But I mean, it's the amount of effort the staff puts into these meetings that make it
so
as efficient as it is.
We can discuss this right on, but I'm going to tell you, this kind of gets a real rub to me, but simply because I honestly feel like that Lowndes County is as transparent as we can possibly be. I don't know how we can be any more transparent than us just backing up when we get to a county commission meeting and say, citizens, everybody in favor, you raise your hand. Everybody opposed, you raise your hand.
We'll start about this.
And enough's enough. I mean, how much more do we need to show before we can show this community that we're as transparent as any government, in my opinion, as you're going to find? And that's it. I know it just gets against my grits. Maybe I've had a long day.
No, I agree with you 100%. I've had a long day.
I'm sorry, what? I wanted an executive. I don't know what I do now.
Forget I brought it up.
Can I get a motion that we enter into executive session?
So moved.
For the purpose of?
Second. What's the purpose? What the purpose is to discuss personnel.